Who is Dick Dady? Dick Dady is the executive director of Citizens Union. Citizens Union is a nonpartisan good government group dedicated to making democracy work for all New Yorkers. Citizens Union serves as a civic watchdog, combating corruption and fighting for political reform. One reason why voters don't participate more in their own government is because good government groups promise to serve as a watchdog on behalf of voters' interests. Some of the issues which Citizens Union, under Dick Dady, have embraced as part of their mission include city budgets, campaign finance, and issues regarding redrawing of boundaries for election districts. Mr. Dady has been the executive director of Citizens Union for about the last 10 years. Over 10 years before he accepted that post, he was the executive director of the Empire State Pride Agenda, which is a statewide organization here in New York State that advocates for LGBT equality. At the Pride Agenda, Mr. Dady helped redraw the boundaries of the 3rd City Council District in Manhattan to help elect Tom Duane in 1991. At the time, Duane's campaign manager was Christine Quinn. In 1990 and 1991, it would make sense that Mr. Dady was advocating for the election of an LGBT candidate to the New York City Council. Earlier this year, that activity was reflected on the Pride Agenda's website, but I learned this week that that information had been removed. What happened? I began researching into Dick Dady's past because of my book, Roots of Betrayal, The Ethics of Christine Quinn, and this is what I discovered. Last week, one of my blogger friends pointed out to me that the State Board of Elections wants Citizens Union to register as a political action committee. How did a good government group become a PAC? What is a good government group doing making political campaign endorsements? Doesn't that show favoritism? Citizens Union is unique among New York good government groups in making endorsements, and at times has caught heat for doing so. For instance, in 2009, the group endorsed Mayor Michael Bloomberg after Mr. Bloomberg extended term limits, a move Citizens Union strongly opposed. Why would Mr. Dady allow Citizens Union to endorse a mayor who overturned voter referenda? Let's look at what else Mr. Dady allows Citizens Union to do. Since 2006, Christine Quinn has administered a speaker's slush fund to curry political favor with community groups. Council Speaker Christine Quinn should be held accountable. It's high time Mayor Bloomberg and the voters held her feet to the fire for the mismanagement of taxpayer dollars during the last decade. It seems like each time Speaker Quinn gets in trouble over her city council slush fund, Dick Dady is there to defend her. Over the last several years, there have been an avalanche of public corruption cases, all tied to Speaker Quinn's slush fund. And what is Mr. Dady's good government response? Dick Dady, the executive director of Citizens Union, a government watchdog group, credited Ms. Quinn with making the funding process more transparent. As Dick Dady of Citizens Union said today, Speaker Quinn's new safeguards would have prevented Councilmember Halloran from succeeding in his alleged scheme. We know from Mr. Dady's past that he supported Christine Quinn's rise to power in 1991. It's suspicious that those actions were removed from the Pride Agenda's website. Mr. Dady's continued support for Christine Quinn compromises the independence of Citizens Union.